Did you know that sunken ships pre-World War II are worth billions? That's right. And the search for dark matter highly depends upon these shipwrecks from hundreds of years ago. But how? Well, it's a long story, and it started on July 16, 1945, in a desert about 56 kilometers southeast of Socorro, New Mexico. This is Dynamic Science, and in this video, we're going to talk about the importance of extremely valuable metals, like steel and lead, that have laid peacefully on the ocean floor, along with corpses of the dead, for decades, and how all of this leads to finding dark matter. Back in the ancient world, around the 13th century BCE, some blacksmiths in India discovered something revolutionary. That iron becomes stronger, harder, and more durable if left with carbon in a furnace. It is from here that steel replaced iron and became a building block of the modern world, the main ingredient of the technological revolution. However, when the USA detonated the very first nuclear bomb in the Trinity Test during World War II, steel around the world changed forever. See, steel is produced in the presence of atmospheric air, but that very same air we breathe contains little molecules left over from approximately 2,000 nuclear tests conducted since 1945. Irradiated coral from Bikini Atoll tests, the snow melted by the Tsar Bomba, and air particles affected by the development of the air-to-air rocket Air 2 Genie are all still radioactive today. Along with these bombs, nuclear accidents like Chernobyl have been generously contributing towards the increased number of radionuclides like cobalt-60 in the atmosphere. These radionuclides are then deposited into the steel around the world, giving it a weak radioactive signature. Yes, the same steel that is used in our everyday lives. And no, it is too weak to cause us any harm. So then, why do we care about the minuscule amounts of radiation, you ask? Well, because you cannot make radiation detectors with radioactive metal, now can you? When you need to make a very sensitive tool to detect radiation, like Geiger counters, or instruments for medical purposes, such as to check radioactive contamination, specific isotopes as they move through a human body, instruments to detect and prevent nuclear smuggling, or astronomical instruments, you have to make tools out of low background steel. Low background steel is steel with a little to none radioactive signature. That is, steel that was produced before World War II with no radioactive imprints on it. Comparably, the so-called radioactive steel is not completely useless for detecting radiation. However, it does make the device less sensitive. It's like you're trying to hear a distant sound when you're in a crowded location. Now the question is, where do we find pre-1945 steel that is untouched by the present day air and shielded from decades of radiation? Well, you heard the first line of the video, so you know the answer. Sunken shipwrecks. But wait, hold up. Haven't they corroded? Well, shipwrecks from the battles of World War I and World War II are covered in marine growth, which restricts the access of oxygen to the remaining steel and keeps these billion-dollar treasures safe. And although this method of extraction is a very expensive procedure, we don't really have another choice. That is, until we can go back in time like Captain America and gather some steel from the past, I'd be keen. Okay, so now you may be wondering how all of this relates to dark matter. Well, it all comes down to lead. Yes, the lead that the ancient Chinese and Greek coins were forged from, along with construction materials and weapons from the Roman Empire. All of it preserved deep down within our oceans and seas. We know that particle physics is a subject that uses highly sensitive detectors to observe or capture the elemental particles emitted in high-speed collisions of bigger particles, or by radioactive metals. But forget plutonium. Plenty of everyday objects, from ceramics to glass to metals and bananas, are radioactive, to varying degrees. And these errant particles from everyday radioactive materials are a major obstacle for particle physicists. So, to prevent these radioactive emissions from hitting the detectors, scientists use lead blocks a few inches thick, as lead tends to absorb particles in its nucleus. However, lead is itself a radioactive material, and at this level of the quantum realm, it is all about sensitivity. Which directs physicists to all of that century-old lead lying in shipwrecks around the world, as its natural radiation is decaying from an unstable lead-210 isotope to a lead-206 isotope, which is stable and no longer spitting out particles, and on top of that, has been shielded by the water from the atmosphere and cosmic rays, making this lead the ideal material to be used in particle physics. Within this field of science, experiments look for the most fundamental building blocks of the cosmos, including dark matter, which makes up 27% of all the stuff in the universe. It is an unseen substance that acts like glue within and between galaxies. However, with our present-day technology, scientists cannot detect it. So, they continue to build all kinds of experiments trying to either detect its existence directly or use the presence of other particles to detect it. And these ancient, low-background materials deep within our oceans is what we use to make the instruments from, to assist us in unlocking these secrets of the universe. But nothing worth it is ever easy, right? Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel for your weekly dose of dynamic science.